This year's Game Changer Lifetime Achievement Award goes to an inspiring journalist who has stood up for journalism and what it ought to do over many, many years. He has helmed an institution that has stood tall to be counted and, more importantly, to be trusted and respected. Here's the winner, ladies and gentlemen, of the Lifetime Achievement Award.
Lifetime Achievement Award. Dr. Gulab Kothari, Chairman and Editor-in-Chief, Patrika Group, for leading a group that has relentlessly, fearlessly, and articulately spoken up for the common man in public interest against powerful influences, be it of the ruling establishments or the advertising class, for showing the world that Vedic science, poetry, literature, and journalism can stay and shine in one being, for staying true to the legacy passed on by his father and Patrika's founder, Karpur Chandra Kulish, of putting the reader first and passing on an expanded organization rooted in the same ethos to the next generation, for growing the media company without compromising on integrity, for making Patrika a role model for journalism.
Members of Media News for You group, members of the jury, friends, with all grace and gratitude, I accept this honor bestowed upon me. And I wish every media house has such awards for excellence so that there will be nothing but excellence all over the media. For your information, Patrika was the first to launch media awards way back in 77-78. And later on, we launched two excellence awards in journalism as well as in social advertising at international level, bearing each $11,000. They are still continuing. And it all started with my father's advice, who said, "We are born with empty-handed and we will die with empty-handed. Nothing belongs to us. So, there is nothing to lose." And this is the final source of courage and inspiration to stand by the people against any odd from the any government. And we did it, we proved it many times. Even in the last government, there was a long standing fight against what is called Kala Kanu, or another one was against the manipulation in the master plan of the cities. And we got through both with the support of the people. Now, along with this, there is another source of inspiration, is what Lord Krishna said in Bhagavad Gita: "Paritranaya sadhunam vinashaya cha duskritam." And this is exactly what a media is supposed to do: to stand by the righteous people and to fight against the evil, which are more powerful today than ever. Patrika thrives on the support of its readers. Now you see, today things are changing from bad to worse, where the media is asking to be called fourth estate of democracy. I can't believe it. We had only three estates, and media was supposed to be a link between people and these three estates. Now, if the media joins the democratic setup, the constitutional level, or with the government, then who is the representation, or who will represent the people? Who will talk about people before the government? This is, nothing can be worse. And because of this, We are facing the problem of fake news and paid news and propaganda news and whatever, Godi media. There are so many names which I never heard about it. I had the best period, I can tell you, with the industry. Those days with all the stalwarts talking only about the ethics in the industry. Today, things have changed. We are taught to return something bad to the society, which today we don't care about. We are all shrinking to become an individual. Everything, we want to create all the wealth or power for the individual use. Whereas we know, no seed can become a tree without burying itself in the earth. And then only you will distribute, you will get fruits, you will turn into a large tree, banyan tree, distribute fruits to the nation. And that is where Patrika teaches every reader to participate, to get in touch with the land or the soil of the nation. You see our Amritam Jalam. With one call, hundreds of thousands of people come during summer, 45 degrees, 47 degrees, and desilt all natural resources of water. It is where you touch the heart of the people. Media, if it wants to transform the society, educate the society, it needs to talk from heart to heart. It needs to talk in the language of the culture and spirituality. Today media is getting away and away from masses. Maybe, I wish, there will be a day things will change again for the better. Thank you.